Praise the Lord, friends. Today morning we have for reflection is the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verse 13 to 35, on a road to Emmaus. It is one of the most inspiring resurrection stories in the Bible, and my personal favorite too. I hope you have read this passage, and it's a very popular and very famous resurrection incident. So I guess you all know it. The evangelist tells us the story unfolds like two of Christ's disciples on a day of Easter Sunday are leaving Jerusalem and leaving the fellowship of believers, showing their back to the cross, are walking towards Emmaus. And while they are walking, they are discussing the recent happenings at Jerusalem and the things happened on Easter Sunday morning. And suddenly a stranger appears on a scene, who is Christ, and draws near them and strikes a conversation. But their eyes were kept away from recognizing Jesus. And as we read further, we come to know that they open their hearts to the Lord and they share all that happened to Jesus and all their pains, hopes and sorrow they share with him. And as the story develops, we see how Jesus first corrects them, reprimands them, and interprets scripture about himself to them. And as they drew near to the village, they asked the Lord, please stay with us. They strongly requested the Lord, please stay with us. Let's take a pause. So what this narrative on the road tells us? There are some beautiful insights, like when we put our hope in the Lord and trust in the Lord and we feel cheated, like everything what we are hoped for has come to an end, when our prayers go unanswered, when our plans have been failed, when our dreams are shattered, when we have a negative image about Christ, of false image about Christ, like the disciples on the way to Emmaus. In Luke chapter 24 verse 21, they are saying that they have hoped in him that he will redeem Israel. They were looking for a political messiah, which Jesus never said about himself. He never said that he is a political messiah. In fact, he said that I have come to seek and save the lost in Luke 19:10. So we too can have a very false image about Christ, like Christ is like a genie who can supply all my needs every time, everywhere, and whatever I wish, he has to give it to me. Or like God is like a superhero, he should always come to rescue and make things right for me whenever I want. This story tells us about man's unfaithfulness and God's faithfulness. At times, we can go partially away from God. And I am talking about the internal journey, interior journey of our hearts and minds, that we may lose our focus from Christ and his resurrection, in the power of his resurrection and his will. And we will think that he is no longer there in our lives. He is almost like dead in our lives. But the Emmaus story tells us that Christ is faithful. Even when we are lost, he comes to save and rescue us. He walks with us in our pain, sorrow, in our journey. He consoles us and comforts us, as he did with the apostles, as he did with the disciples on a way to Emmaus. They were very hopeless, living with unbelief and sad when they were walking towards Emmaus. But when Christ started interpreting scriptures to them, it proposes us that they were consoled and comforted. That is one of the reasons they asked him, Lord, please stay with us. So they were finding his teaching interesting, his words affecting their hearts. As Psalm 119 verse 130 says, the unfolding of your word gives light. It gives understanding to the simple. Psalm 36 verse 9 says, for with you is the fountain of life. In your light we see light. Yes, brothers and sisters, God is light and God's word is light. It drives away darkness and confusions. As Psalm 119 verse 105 says, thy word, O Lord, is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Scripture is very important for our spiritual journey. That's what the Emmaus story tells us, and how Christ used scripture to console, comfort, and to bring clarity in their hearts and minds about God and His kingdom. And as in Isaiah chapter 50 verse 4 says, the Lord has given me a tongue of a teacher so that I may know how to sustain a weary with the word. That's what the Lord was doing on a way to Emmaus to His disciples. He was comforting the weary with His word. And that's what we are called to do. When we find our brother and sisters in pain, in suffering, in confusions, we too, as the disciples of the Lord, are called to sustain a weary with the word, with hope. As we read further in the story, the disciples ask the Lord to stay with him. This incident tells us that Jesus doesn't come into our lives forcefully, and he comes with invitation. So we have to urge the Lord with a strong faith, Lord, stay with us. And Jesus accepts their invitation and walks into their home. And the evangelist tells us that during the breaking of the bread, the disciples recognized him. Here it is a very beautiful insight for each one of us, that for the breaking of the bread, when we go for Mass, we have to first get filled with the scripture, as the Lord was doing with disciples on their way to Emmaus. We have to be touched by the scriptures. We have to be prepared by the scriptures for the breaking of the bread. And as soon as Jesus broke the bread and gave it to them, their eyes were open and they recognized him. And the first sentence this said, that does not our hearts were burning within us while he was opening the scriptures to us. So to have a worthy participation in the Mass, let our hearts burn by the word of God. The burning of the heart tells that they were being receptive. Their heart was moving from unbelief to belief, from hopelessness to hope, from confusion to clarity. So in our lives too, the burning of the hearts is important. The word of God should challenge us, sanctify us, purify us, and transform us, provided we are open to His word. And as soon they recognize the Lord in the breaking of the bread, at that same hour they went back to Jerusalem. So now the story is coming to a happy ending. It started with sadness and hopelessness. Now in this story they are filled with joy. And now they are running back to Jerusalem to tell the apostles that he is risen. So brothers and sisters, resurrection of our Lord inspires us to believe in the hopeless situation. It challenges us to believe against all odds in Christ, for he is truly alive. We have witnesses of lots of saints, martyrs, who have given their life for Christ, believing in His resurrection and in the eternal life. and we have to pray that the Lord may open our hearts and minds to recognize Him in the Eucharist. We have to pray that He may prepare our hearts through His Word, so that we can, when we participate in the Holy Mass, we can experience His power and grace, and our eyes may recognize Him. One more beautiful insight is this, in this Gospel passage is, in recognizing Christ, they recognizing themselves. They receive their mission to proclaim Christ, to tell about the Lord to others. So too for us, we should pray that we may recognize Him and find our mission in this world, in the church, in the kingdom of God. And we too, like disciples and the apostles, can say, the Lord has risen indeed, and He has appeared to me. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, You are the Good Shepherd who comes and seek and save the lost. Lord, we ask You to come in our life journey and seek us, save us, Lord. You console and comfort us, Lord. And You draw us near to Yourself, O Lord. You strengthen our hearts and minds, Lord, to believe in You, to hope in You. And when You send us on a mission, give us a grace, O Lord, to fulfill that mission by the power of Your Spirit, Lord. Thank You, Lord. Praise You, Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord is risen indeed. Happy Easter.